Hi everyone, welcome back to the episode of Ask Dr. Nick. My name is Dr. Nick Schudelkoffer and I work for the Neurologic Wellness Institute. And today's question is, do concussions cause an increased risk of lower extremity or leg injuries? And the answer, the short answer is yes, it does, according to a couple separate studies, which is an interesting thing to look at because we think about concussions as a brain injury. And so you would think that once the concussion heals and the person, the student, the athlete has no symptoms, then they should be all good to go and it shouldn't lead to any detrimental effects down the road. However, that is not necessarily the case. I'll show a couple studies here that show how a concussion, when the athlete returns to play, that within 90 days, they're more likely to have a lower extremity injury after they have supposedly healed from that concussion. The problem is that concussions have a lot of like silent objectifying, silent things that can cause decreased reaction time, decreased sensory motor coordination, decreased high eye-hand coordination, decreased ability to see peripherally in our peripheral field properly to then improve on reaction time. And so there are many things that can happen with a concussion leading to this poor motor coordination, this poor ability to make proper decisions. And that can then predispose people, especially athletes, to injuries down the road. And these two articles are going to be looking at lower extremity injuries or leg injuries. So let's just take a peek at each of them. The first one is out of the University of Wisconsin-Madison. Okay, it was published in 2016. And let's just take a look. So the purpose was to look at what are the odds of sustaining an acute lower extremity injury during a 90-day period after the return to play of concussions, okay, in NCAA athletes. So they included 87 cases of concussion among 75 athletes. More of them were men, but there were 17 women. They either played football, soccer, hockey, softball, basketball, wrestling, or volleyball. And it was between 2011 and 2014, so 4 years about. Again, they had included controls for each one of these individuals that were concussed. The controls still had their age matched, tried to be also position or so sport specific and position specific, and they included the same 90-day period up for those controls. Okay, and so sport, team, sex, game played, position, they tried to control for everything. There was 182 controls, so basically a little over double the amount of concussions. They kept it equal when it came to men and women, obviously, because they were matched controls. So they found that the incidence of these acute lower extremity injuries were higher among them recently concussed. So there was 15 lower extremity injuries or leg injuries among the concussed versus 17 among the matched controls. So that is a 17% versus 9% when they looked at it. And this meant that they were 2.5 times more likely to have a lower extremity injury if they were concussed than the non-concussed athletes. So let's just look at a couple things here. These were the amounts here. Okay, so possible explanations. So I want to look at when we'll just kind of run through them all. So changes in neurocognitive function, motor functioning in the days and weeks after the injury could be essential there. And that's the idea that I was saying with decision making, right? They said one possible explanation would be detraining due to the missed time. But again, this was highly unlikely because they were all matched controls that may have been out for a couple weeks. The typical return to play, I missed up there, was 21 days. So it was 21 days, and so here they have the concussed group was on average 32 days removed, while the control was 33 days removed. So it's most likely not the case. other studies, they've showed that athletes with history of concussion have worse visual and auditory reactive times. Okay, they have longer latencies. They can have different attentional resources, therefore have poorer processing speed. They can also have poor clinical tests like dynamic postural stability, or basically just being able to stand and then have proper postural, and then dynamic, as in while moving, having proper dynamic stability. And then lastly, kind of the cerebral functioning of postural control, and the ability while we're walking to have a good amount of velocity and balance on one leg versus the other. Okay, so that one was 2016. This one is from 2017. Very similar thing. Concussion may increase the risk of subsequent lower extremity musculoskeletal injury in the collegiate athletes. It was from the University of Florida and University of Texas. Okay, so they looked at more people over a longer period of time. And so from 2006 to 2013, they used men's football and then women's basketball, soccer, and lacrosse. They had, it says 52 male, 21 female, but that was definitely, they ended up including more. I will go check that out. No, it must have been that. Okay, I thought this one had a few more concussions than just 90. So, but in the results, again, they had lower extremity musculoskeletal injuries occurred at a higher rate in the concussed, 45 out of 90, so 50% compared to the non-concussed, 30 to 180, 148, which is 20%. Okay, so, and again, overall the number of days lost due to injury was similar between these concussed and non-concussed athletes. So again, we're just saying the same thing. Let's go down to this one. So basically, their odds ratio, the last one was 2.48, their odds ratio is 3.39, so you're 3.3 times more likely to sustain a lower extremity musculoskeletal injury if you were concussed than if you weren't concussed. Here they're citing that article that I just talked about, the 2.48 one from Brooks at the University of Wisconsin-Madison. And again, possible explanations. Here real quick, the female athletes were a little bit less likely than the males, so 2.75 was their odds ratio versus 3.72 for the males. And then the possible explanations, as we're talking about, the neuromuscular control could be directly impaired due to problems with the motor cortex in concussed athletes. We know that voluntary muscle contraction can be inhibited. We know that there's this altered motor cortex excitability has been observed in populations with ACL injuries, chronic ankle instability, so that can have a direct correlation into more instability in the legs and therefore promote these direct musculoskeletal injuries. And then we know that possibly neurocognition, so more of that decision making and the quick decision making that can be needed in sport. So I really think this one is cool because it really connects the combination of brain and nervous system to musculoskeletal system and shows how the brain is so important for controlling the musculoskeletal system and how a concussion can then lead to these problems down the line, especially within that initial 90-day period. But if the brain is not fixed following the concussion properly and the brain wants to compensate for things, then those compensations might lead to or predispose people to injuries later on. So if you have any questions or comments, please leave them below. I'd love to hear topics for or suggestions for future topics and videos. Please let me know and have a great day.